In the previous topic, we have seen the domain name security extension, and which is pertaining to the safeguarding of the domain name security request and replies. Now we'll move on to the other secure protocols of the network or secure implementation of the network communication, which is called virtual private network. Here the name virtual means that it itself is telling you that it's somewhat it will be looking like a private network, but there is no direct private network, but these private networks will be established on the public infrastructure. That is the reason we'll call it as the virtual private network. For example, if you look at there is a user system with IP security or IP. IP security is a module, security module that will be used in the virtual private networks. Not only IP security, we'll use several other methods. There may be several other methods can be used for implementing this virtual private networks. In that, IP security is one type of security mechanism that we'll see in the next topics, that IP security and how it will be implemented. Now, this user system wants to establish a communication with the a server which is on a particular organizational network, and another server which is on another organizational network, or a computer which is on another organizational network. Now this system wants to establish a connection between these computers. For that it may use the public infrastructure called internet. But even though it uses the internet, there is a very secure channel must be established, and this channel should be private to the computer to which you are communicating. That means this particular channel should be highly private, but this channel will be created on the public infrastructure. That is the reason we'll call it as a virtual private network. So by this time you come to know what is VPN. VPN means virtual private network. We are going to establish a secure private channel over the public infrastructure. In order to create that, we may use several other protocols like IPsec and point-to-point protocols, and many other protocols are there that we'll see afterwards. Private network, in general, private network is nothing but uses the leased lines. They will be having dedicated lines. Secure or dedicated lines will be there. They will communicate over that. If the RB personnel want to speak each other, so there will be a hotline or some secure channel will be there. There is a private line, like only private line, only via the private line only the officers can speak each other. For example, country. There should be a communication between the country heads. Okay, they will establish a private channel. A secure channel will be created. Only via that secure channel only these country heads can speak each other. So that is what is called private network, which uses the leased line. But what is the problem with this particular secure channels or leased lines? For example, there is a business person or a marketing or a executive will be there who may go around the country or may out of the country also, but still wants to establish a communication with the company server. In such a cases, he cannot have this leased lines wherever he go. Obviously he has to use the public infrastructure like internet. So by using the public infrastructure, that particular employee will create a secure private channel that will communicate with the company server. This way of doing is said to be the virtual private network. Okay, so the virtual private network uses the public internet but will be having a secure tunnel between that computer, that is employee's computer, and the organizational server. when the virtual private network secure channel was established at the with the layer 2 layer 2 in the ISO OSI protocol stack is data link layer. If the secure channel established at the data link layer, then it said to be layer 2 VPN. If the secure channel established with the network layer, then it said to be layer 3 virtual private network. Customers layer 2 packets are encapsulated and delivered at the other end. Looks like two end are on the same LAN and are the same wire. Means it will look like this. It means the these particular two computers are on the same LAN. Like that, you will get a feeling, in a virtual feeling. Provides Ethernet connectivity. Works for all layer 3 protocols. And these are the other features like virtual private wire services, virtual private LAN services. And this layer 2 VPN was defined under the request for comment 4664 frameworks for L2 VPNs published under September 2006 by engineering task force. While coming to the layer 3 VPN, provides layer 3 connectivity. Layer 3 connectivity means first layer is physical layer, next layer is data link layer, next layer is network layer. That is at the IP level, that is in network layer level, this VPN will be established. So this is what called provides the layer 3 connectivity. So looks like the two customers routers are connected each other. While coming to this layer 2, the computers are connected each other via single LAN. It will look like that. But here the routers are connected each other. Like that, they will get a feeling. That is a virtual feeling. Usually designed for the IP packets. So since whenever you use the layer 3 VPN to provide security for IP, since it is at the network layer means IP only, okay? The network layer means it's you are going to communicate with the IP packets. So to have the security or to have the secure tunnel, we use the IPsec, okay? IPsec will be used. That is what we have seen in the diagram here. A system uses the IPsec and will send the data. So that we'll see afterwards what is IPsec and all. So what are the other protocols that can be used to establish the IP virtual private network tunneling? So these are the protocols. GRE, that is generic routing encapsulation, which was defined under the request for comment 1701 and 702. Point to point tunneling protocol, layer 2 tunneling protocol, IPsec, MPLS, multi protocol label switching. So these are the various methods that can be used for establishing the secure tunnel between the computers over the public medium. In the generic routing encapsulation, which was defined under the request for comment 1701 and 1702, here any generic X over any generic Y can be established. That means here X and Y is the first party and second party anywhere. Or from the Y to X also, in any way, this particular thing was established. What it will do is, it will be having an optional checksum, loose or strict source routing, and some keys will be available. So with which a secure tunnel will be established. Keys used to authenticate the source, and over IPv4, GRE packets use the protocol of type 47, that is the code of the protocol, will be used. Allows router visibility into application level header. Restricted to a single provider network, end-to-end provider will be used. So the packet structure, whenever any packet was sent over the secure channel, delivery header, GRE header, that is generic routing encapsulation header, and the payload, the original data. This is the way the packet will be transmitted. While coming to the PPTP, point-to-point tunneling protocol, the name itself is point-to-point, okay? This in general will be based upon the layer 2, we can say. So it was developed jointly by the Microsoft, Ascend, USR, 3Com and ECA Telematics. PPTP server for NT4 and clients for the NT9598. This is somewhat very older one. We have seen this PPTP when you have the dial-up connections. Okay. Whenever the dial-up connections are there, like BSNL dial-up connections, you might have seen this particular PPTP tunnels and PPTP establishment. So here NT means NT, Windows NT means Windows, it's not a network technology, it is a new technology. Okay, Windows NT means new technology, not network technology. So PPTV server, internet service provider, maybe anyone, maybe BSNL or Airtel or whatever may be, with which you will go for a dial-up connection, and network access server and client. This is the way how the PPTP tunnel will work. Whenever it was happened, then the packet structure will be like this. The private network, the PPTP server will be having the packet like this. PPP, point to point protocol, IP, GRE. That means either whatever the packet you want that you can use here, whatever the protocol you want, you can use here. And the data will be encrypted. This particular data will be like this. IP or IPX, net BUI. These are the packet forms, data forms. And this data forms, once it is encrypted, then at the receiving end, it will be like this. Point to point protocol, then the data that what you have included, and the original data. So while coming to this L2TP, it is layer 2 tunneling protocol. Layer 2 tunneling protocol is a combination of two things. One is layer 2 forwarding, which was developed by the Cisco router and Cisco company. This L2TP is equal to layer 2 forwarding plus point to point tunneling. If you add these two, it will become L2TP. Combines the best features of L2F and PPTP. Easy upgradation from the L2F to the point-to-point tunneling protocol will be there in this. Allows the point-to-point protocol frames to be sent over the non-IP. Because it is at the layer 2, so non-IP frame relay, ATM, asynchronous transmission mode, ATM networks, also used in this particular topic. Allows multiple tunnel between the same endpoints. Better header compression and support flow control also in this L2TP. In the version 3, this is a basic version in which you have the frame relay, okay, and at the frame level it will work. Frames is nothing but the data link layer, okay. In case of L2TP version 3, it is providing support for the IP networks also, VPN over the IP networks. Okay, next one is this is V3 is the generalizes it for other protocols over the packet switched data networks. IP networks is nothing but packet switching networks, packet networks. So can also handle the high level data link control, Ethernet, 802.1Q, VLAN and all. See, among all these protocols, IPsec is very popularly used, and remaining all are outdated and they are not much used in the industry. But they exist. They still exist. If anyone wants, they can use it. But the IPsec and other mechanisms are more reliable and more flexible and reliable also compared to these things. So there is a reason people for sophistication purpose, they simply moved on to the IP security kind of thing. While coming to the OpenVPN, it is a software. Most popular open source virtual private network software for client and servers can be implemented in firmware also. Firmware means hardware implementation of software. Software implementation of hardware is said to be firmware. For example, firewall is there. In the beginning stages, firewall is a hardware kind of thing. Some hardware circuit will be there that will be placed at the network firmware. Now the firewall is implemented as a software within the operating system. So software implementation of hardware is said to be firmware. Here DDWRT, OpenWRT, these are the firmwares, most popular firmware. Available on most operating systems like Windows, Linux and other operating systems. This OpenVPN. Many routers come with OpenVPN support. And it does not use, this OpenVPN does not use, the specialty of this is, it does not use the IPsec also. What we have discussed is this point-to-point tunneling protocol, layer-2 tunneling protocol, IPsec. We tell that among all these things, IPsec is better used. But this OpenVPN won't use this IPsec. But what it will use? It will use the OpenSSL library. That means VPN is an environment that can be established either via IKE, or IPsec, or PPTP, or L2TP, our this secure socket layer SSL, our transport layer security. So in many ways this VPN environment can be established. So usually people will confuse that IPsec means VPN. No, IPsec is not VPN. IPsec is a protocol that is used for establishing a secure channel. Okay, IPsec may be used in several places also. Okay, so uses open SSL library for SSL or TLS on TCP and UDP. Provides all encryption authentication methods in OpenSSL. Example, pre-shared keys, certificates, users, username and passwords, and all. We'll see afterwards SSL topic also in our network security protocols. OpenSSL allows servers to issue certificates to the clients, extensible using modular plugins, and it uses a single TCP or UDP port. This is OpenVPN. Multiple ports will not be used here. And also can traverse the network address translation and also firewalls. So these are the features of the open virtual private network. How to configure the virtual private network? So view the video of VPN settings that I have made previously, how to establish VPN on the Linux operating system, and also download and test this particular Onion router, that is Tor. Tor is a very famous VPN router, VPN browser. Okay, download and install this browser, Tor browser, from this particular thing website, and open the Tor browser and a regular browser, and type the what is my IP. So in Tor browser you will find different IP, and in regular browser you will find the normal IP that what you have set for that. So this means whenever the VPN is enabled, then the same IP will not be used. So different IP will be used. So by the VPN clients. So Tor browser will also show you different IP address than the regular browser. That is generally what you have set for the system. So repeat the previous step in both browsers and capture the results, and see what is the difference in the Tor browser IP address and the regular browser IP address. Browse to so and so to get the list of Onion routers that are available. So these are for the reading purpose, to gain more understanding of what is in the virtual private network and how it will be established. And you can view this particular video for how to configure VPN on the Linux operating system. This particular thing was made by me when I am discussing the intrusion detection and prevention systems lecture. So you may also view that video and can establish the virtual private network. So this is related to the VPN. So in this lecture, we have seen the virtual private network and its what are the different protocols used in this VPN, and how to configure the VPN, and from links were provided.